that Kuwait summit, the first ever Arab Economic Summit, and where Gaza, of course, was the main topic of conversation, and the failure to establish a fund and the postponing of the establishment of that fund to next month. We can go live now to Damascus to speak to the deputy leader of Hamas in exile, Musa Abu Marzouk. First of all, there have been demonstrations here in Tehran, and the demonstrators here in Tehran say it was a victory for Hamas. Thousands of people have been injured, 1,000 people dead, 1,000 Palestinians. Why is it a victory?
Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. Of course, it is very clear victory. When the aggression start, they point five objective for this boy. First of all, to remove Hamas from governing Gaza Strip, to stop the rocket launching from Gaza. They stopped to brought any kind of weapon to Gaza, to bring Mahmoud Abbas to power in Gaza again, for changing the formula. They're trying to make good picture for the leader of Israeli and the army of the Israeli. Now, if you're talking about the objectives, which one of those the Israeli aggression accomplished or success? If he fail to accomplish any of these objectives, what does that mean? Any war, if you didn't accomplish the objective of that war, that mean you defeated. That means the other side winner. There is no other choice. If you win or lose, now if you didn't win, what does mean that for the other side? This is the reason. We didn't choose to go to war. They make the aggression. They put all of the objectives. They failed to success. Then that mean Hamas success. Yes, we know they have that much of weapon, that much of power. There is no balance of power.
If they hit
the building and destroy it.
Hamas
they
says
hit the children and kill them.
Hamas
they
says
hit the women and kill them.
Hamas but says the ceasefire will last
another,
a week. Hamas says
fail.
Sorry to interrupt, Musa Abu Marzouk, but Hamas says the ceasefire will last a week to give time for the Israelis to withdraw. What happens if they don't withdraw all their forces? And have your people been talking with Ban Ki-moon, who is in Gaza now?
We don't mind if Ban Ki-moon talk with us. We prepare for everything. We provide complete security for Ban Ki-moon, and we're gonna help the United Nations employee anywhere in Gaza Strip, and we welcome any meeting with him, but this decision, it's belong to him. For the Israeli, if they didn't withdraw completely from Gaza Strip, we're gonna start resist those troops in Gaza Strip.
And the $2 billion talked about in Kuwait for the reconstruction of Gaza, do you think Hamas will get that $2 billion or it'll be given to Mahmoud Abbas?
This is not our objective to get the money, and it is very clear for us it shouldn't go to Mahmoud Abbas. What we need, what we want this money go to the people directly, go to the people who destroy their homes, go to the universities, to school, and they can do that by themselves. Or they can send any advisors or somebody to monitor their money in Gaza Strip. We don't mind what is the way or the best way to send the money and give it to people. But but we will never accept any step like this to send the money to Mahmoud Abbas.
You trusted Hosni Mubarak because Hamas leaders went to Cairo and they were in constant discussions, even when there was a plan in Qatar. How was it for Hamas talking with the Egyptians when the war was still on? And how was the Egyptian position? Because the Egyptian position in Kuwait seemed very different to the position of, say, Bashar al-Assad or the position even of Amr Musa.
As you know, there is a clear position for the Egyptian side about what going on in Palestine. And they very clear about this. They stop behind Mahmoud Abbas and they support Mahmoud Abbas very strongly. And they don't like to see us in Gaza Strip or in the political agenda or in the Palestinian political system. But in reality, Hamas, they couldn't remove it from the Palestinian agenda or Palestinian regime. They're trying the world, the whole world, the quartet, the Israel, the Mahmoud Abbas, they're trying to remove Hamas from the power in Gaza in many ways, by boycott, by the internal war, by the Israeli aggression. They're trying many times to change the formula by Israel, by Mohammed Dahlan, by the siege, by all of the, they're trying all of the means, but they didn't found any result about all of these kind of projects. We're dealing with the political agenda, and the Egyptian is the mediator. We're dealing with him. We want to reach the agreement, and we know exactly what is their position, and we know exactly our position, and we didn't scare to talk about all of these things directly. We have
your
to
leader,
talk with the Egyptian. They are our neighbor.
Your leader often spoke about the war on Gaza as being